Are the points on these two circles traveling at the same velocity, or are they traveling at different velocities? I want you to think about that question. We'll come back to it in just a second. What we have is we have two different types of velocities. We have what's called linear velocity, and we have what's called angular velocity. Linear velocity comes from this idea that distance equals rate times time, which we learned about way back in the day. If I took this relationship and divided by t on both sides, we'd have that our rate, which we'll call velocity, is equal to distance over time. So our linear velocity is divided as the distance divided by time. Write that down. That's a relationship we need to know. In our second relationship, this is very similar. We have angular velocity, and it's measured as an angle over time. So if we were looking at this, we would say that the angular velocity times the time is equal to the change in the angle. But we're not quite as comfortable with this relationship, but I think it connects well with the linear velocity relationship. But write this down. Our angular velocity, which we'll use the Greek letter omega, is equal to the angle or the change in degrees over time. Instead of a change in distance over time, we're doing a change in degrees over time. Now, if we bounce back to our example, what we have is we have two different points. We have this point here on the left, and we have this point here on the right. Now, it is obvious that this point on the right is actually traveling at a faster speed. If they make one full revolution in the same time, this one's traveling a greater distance in the same time. So its linear velocity is greater. Now, here's the thing. Think about how the angle is changing. This angle, these two points change 360 degrees in the same amount of time. So while this point right here has a greater linear velocity, the angular velocity of both is equal. So if I asked you which one had the greater velocity, it's a trick question. Because the point on the right has a greater linear velocity, but they have an equal angular velocity. So if we bounce back to our definition, I think our definition will make a little more sense now. Our angular velocity is independent of the radius. It doesn't matter how big your circle is. It's just however many degrees you change in a given set of time. Both of these went 360 degrees in the same amount of time, so both circles had the same angular velocity. However, that larger circle traveled a greater distance in the set amount of time, so it had a greater linear velocity. But let's see how we can use these two relationships to solve problems. So the second hand of a clock is 7 inches long, so we're going to find the linear velocity. So if this is 7 inches long, I want to find the linear velocity of a tip on the end of the second hand in inches per second. What we know is this point right here, this point that's the tip of the second hand, we know the distance that it travels in 60 seconds is going to be the circumference of the circle. Doesn't it make sense that the tip of the second hand travels the circumference of the circle in 60 seconds? And our circumference is given by 2 pi r. So if I punch this into my calculator and do 2 times pi times 7 divided by 60, that's going to be 0.73, roughly 0.73 inches per second, okay? In every second, the tip of this second hand travels about 0.73 inches around the circle. Now let's find the angular velocity. If we're finding the angular velocity, we know that in 60 seconds, we travel 360 degrees. We'll keep this in terms of degrees. Well, if I divide those, that just means it's traveling 6 degrees per second. So this would be a linear velocity. This would be an angular velocity. Let's do our second example. The blades on a ceiling fan are 3 feet long. When set to medium speed, the blades rotate at 12 revolutions per second. So let's first find the linear speed. I have a fan blade that's 3 feet long, okay, and it's asking for an answer in feet per second, so I don't have to change any of my units. But what we know is it tells us that in every 1 second, the fan blade travels 12 revolutions. That means it takes the circumference of the circle times 12. So this would be 1 revolution around, and it does that 12 times every second. So let's punch that into our calculator. And I get about 226.19 feet per every second. Is that a realistic number? I have no idea. I made up this question. I don't know how fast fan blades spin off the top of my head. Now let's find the angular speed of the blade in radians per second. Oh, I did radians this time. So in 1 second, it makes 12 revolutions. So that means you take 1 revolution would be 2 pi radians, and it does that 12 times, and then we know that's every second. So I can punch this into my calculator, or let's leave it in terms of pi. It looks like we get 24 pi radians every second as an angle of rotation. Now, the thing about this is If the fan blades were longer, if we took a 4-foot fan blade, this number would increase because that point on the end of the fan blade is traveling a greater distance. But if we increase the length of the fan blade, this number would not increase because it's still doing the same number of revolutions per second. And that's kind of how you can find linear velocity and angular velocity.